And he appreciated Blessed Giacomo Alberione's initiatives to use the media to evangelize and proclaim the gospel. On his website, he put, "The more Eucharist we receive, the more we will become like Jesus, so that on this earth we will have a foretaste of heaven." Acquire the habit of speaking to God as if you were alone with Him, familiarly and with confidence and love, as to the dearest and most loving of friends. This quote comes to us from St. Alphonsus Liguori. Another week going by. How is the family doing? How are you doing? Today we'll be continuing the series They Inspired Me, so stay tuned for the rest of the videos in this section of this series. And instead of doing the 5 per video, saints or blesseds, we're gonna have to break it up into 3s. This is to speed up the process for both watching and intaking the information. I realize that informational videos should be under a certain time limit. I don't know, that's just me, but it's something that we're going to do now. Again, the disclaimer, for these people that you will either come to me or learn about, the process of canonization can change their title. Some will be recognized as saints through the intense study and miracles attributed to these people, and others will continue to be recognized as venerables or blesseds or such. So with that in mind, let's jump into today's video. Today's gospel inspiration comes to us from Proverbs chapter 3, verses 3 and 4. "Do not let kindness and truth leave you behind. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart, so you will find favor and good repute in the sight of God and man." Today's first venerable is Varghese Payapili Palakapili. I hope I said that right. He was a Syro Malabar priest from the Indian state of Kerala, and he was born on August 8, 1876. Payapili is an ancient St. Thomas Christian family in India, which is recognized as the Christians that were baptized by St. Thomas the Apostle in the first century. So there's a major connection here. Varghese was educated in the parish school at Paramanur and at St. Albert's School. He received his religious education and training from the seminary at Puttenpally and the papal seminary at Kandy in Sri Lanka. He would be ordained a priest on December 21st, 1907, and Varghese served as a parish priest in these different locations. During his time at the church in Arakusa, he began the St. Mary's Higher Secondary School. He would also make some land purchases for the church, thus making it self-sufficient. According to one of his pupils at the time, the school where he had managed had become what he described as a seabed of priestly vocations. Varghese would be known as a good mediator, and people would approach him for help to their problem. He would go on to found the Congregation of the Sisters of the Destitute. He died of typhoid on October 5th, 1929. He was declared a servant of God by Varki Vatayatil, Major Archbishop of the Syro Malabar Catholic Church, on September 6, 2009, and would be declared venerable by Pope Francis on April 14th, 2018. Today's second venerable is Carlo Acuti. He was an Italian Roman Catholic teenager born in London, England on May 3, 1991, and was actually very well known for documenting Eucharistic miracles around the entire world, and then cataloging them all onto a website that he himself created. Unfortunately though, months before his death from leukemia, but we'll get to that point later. Three things would describe him: his cheerfulness, his computer skills, and his deep devotion to the Eucharist. As a young child, he would grow a devotion to the Mother of God and would pray rosaries constantly as a sign of his devotion to her. He would attend Mass consistently to receive the Eucharist. Acuti's also made his confession once a week. He also had several models as his guides for life. And these are big people too. St. Francis of Assisi, St. Francisco and Jacinto Marto when they were still blessed, St. Dominic Savio, St. Tarsus, and St. Bernadette Saborius. And one thing that would stand out to me regarding Acuti's was his efforts with his friends. Now follow me. In particular, those whose parents were divorcing. He would invite those friends to his home to support them during that difficult process. He loved traveling, but loved to visit Assisi more than any other place. He would contract leukemia and would offer his pain for both the Pope at that time, Pope Benedict XVI, and for the Universal Church, in which he said, "I offer all the suffering I will have to suffer for the Lord, for the Pope, and the Church." He asked his parents to take him on pilgrimages to the sites of all the known Eucharistic miracles in the world, but this would not happen due to his worsening health. In 2005, Akutsis decided to make a website dedicated to careful cataloging of each reported miracle, and he appreciated Blessed Giacomo Alberione's initiatives to use the media to evangelize and proclaim the gospel. On his website, he put, "The more Eucharist we receive, the more we will become like Jesus, so that on this earth we will have a foreshadowing of heaven." Fortunately, he died on October 12, 2006, due to his complications from leukemia. Pope Francis declared him to be a venerable on July 5, 2018, and Francis would also approve a miracle attributed to him, which enables Akutsis to now be beatified. Our last venerable of the day is Venerable Pauline Marie Jericot. Jericot was born on July 22, 1799 in Lyon, France. Her father owned a silk factory in Lyon, France. Her brother, Phileas, was a missionary in Quagnam. She would hear a sermon on vanity which made a deep impression on her. At the age of 17, after a serious fall, and then to top that off, the death of her mother, Jericot began to lead a life of intense prayer, and on Christmas Day, 1816, took a vow of perpetual virginity. As a member of the association founded by the Fathers of the Foreign Missions of Paris, Jericot was a pioneer of organized missionary cooperation. Along with the women employees in the silk factory run now by her sister and brother-in-law, she resolved to help the missions with prayers and a small weekly contribution of one penny, okay, just one penny a week from each person involved. The effort would grow on and would lead to the founding of the Society for the Propagation of the Faith in 1822, dedicated to helping missionary efforts worldwide. On May 3rd, 1922, Pope Pius XI declared the Society for the Propagation of the Faith pontifical. She is the founder of the Society of the Propagation of the Faith and the Living Rosary Association. As a member of the lay Dominicans, Jericot's spiritual director for many years was Jean Marie Vianney, also known as Saint John Vianney. And funny enough, on the day that I actually filmed this video, it is his feast day. I mean, I'm just saying that this happened, so it's on record. In 1822, she arranged the printing and distribution of religious literature, and she believed that the information about the missions should be publicized, which is actually a good thing. Later, the future society would publish the annals, which contain reports from the various mission territories aimed at increasing interest in the society and the missions. She would go through some difficult times due to the mismanagement of those who she would leave in charge, and she would be forced to declare bankruptcy in 1862. She died on January 9, 1862 in Lyon. On February 25, 1963, Pope St. John the 23rd declared Jericot venerable. And as early as May 26, 2020, Pope Francis authorized the Congregation for the Causes of Saints to promulgate a decree recognizing a miracle attributed to Jericot's intercession. So for now, she is also slated to be recognized as a blessing. Question of the week: what stands out to you from the lives of the venerables? Let me know in the comment sections down below. Go and check out The Living Heart. The link for the website and page are down below. So stop by and go check out all the goodies you can get, and make sure you support. In the following weeks, there will be an announcement made, so stay tuned for that. That will be on the Instagram page, so make sure you check it out. Prayer, more prayer, even more prayer. Make sure y'all continue to pray. Stay blessed. God bless. Blessings to all. We're pushing forward, so do not lose faith. Check out these other videos over here and hit the subscribe button to be subscribed to the channel. Stay safe, and I'll see you all in the next video.